Every time you open an app, save a file, or even press a key, something in the background makes it all work smoothly. That something is the operating system. It's the core software that manages your computer's hardware, runs your programs, and keeps everything in sync. But how does it actually work, and what's inside it? Let's take a closer look. An operating system, or OS, is the crucial software that manages a computer or device's hardware and software, making it possible for users to interact with their devices. Acting as an intermediary between the user and the machine, the OS ensures that everything runs smoothly by providing a platform for applications to execute and managing access to hardware resources. From simple tasks like opening a file to complex operations like managing memory and networking, the OS makes it all possible. Without an operating system, a computer would be unable to perform any tasks and the hardware would remain inert. It's the backbone of any device, whether it's a smartphone, laptop, or server, and its efficient operation is key to the overall performance of the system. Now let's look at the core responsibilities that allow the OS to keep everything running smoothly. One of its key functions is handling system resources, deciding how and when hardware like the CPU, memory, and storage should be used. It also coordinates processes by starting, pausing, or terminating programs, ensuring they don't interfere with each other. The OS keeps track of memory usage, allocating space when needed and freeing it when not. It also takes care of file systems, managing how data is stored and retrieved on disk. Another important function is controlling input and output, making sure devices like keyboards, printers, and network cards communicate effectively with the rest of the system. Together, these functions form the invisible framework that allows software and hardware to work in harmony. Next, let's take a look at the core components of every operating system, the kernel and the shell. The kernel is the heart of the OS, responsible for direct communication with the hardware. It controls critical functions like managing the CPU, handling memory, and ensuring that different processes run efficiently without interfering with one another. Depending on how it's structured, the kernel can be monolithic, where all services run in a single space, like in Linux, or a microkernel, where only the most essential functions operate in the core while others run separately, as seen in some embedded systems. There are also other kernel types, such as hybrid kernels, used in Windows, and nanokernels, each offering different design trade-offs. Surrounding the kernel is the shell, which acts as the user interface for interacting with the system. This can be a command line interface, such as Bash on Linux or PowerShell on Windows, or a graphical user interface, like Windows Explorer or macOS Finder. While the kernel does the heavy lifting behind the scenes, the shell provides users with a way to give commands and control the system. Now let's look at the different types of operating systems. A single-user OS is designed for one person at a time, while a multi-user OS allows multiple users to access system resources simultaneously, common in servers and mainframes. In terms of task handling, a multitasking OS can run several applications concurrently, like Windows or Mac OS, whereas a single-tasking OS focuses on executing one program at a time, typical in simpler or older systems. Desktop operating systems are built for personal computers and laptops, offering a full graphical interface and wide hardware support. Mobile operating systems, like Android and iOS, are optimized for touchscreen devices with power and resource limitations. Embedded OSs run on specialized hardware such as smart appliances, medical devices, or routers, often with minimal interfaces. Finally, real-time operating systems are designed for time-critical tasks, where responses must occur within strict time constraints, common in robotics, industrial control systems, and aerospace technology. Keep in mind that there are even more specialized types out there, and that each one of them plays a vital role in powering the digital world around us. Before we dive deeper, it's important to understand how the operating system actually starts, through what's called the boot process. When you power on a computer, a well-orchestrated sequence of events kicks off. It begins with the BIOS or UEFI firmware, which performs basic hardware checks and locates the bootloader, a small program responsible for loading the operating system into memory. Once the bootloader runs, it loads the kernel, the core of the OS, which then takes control of the system and starts initializing essential services, drivers, and user interfaces. At this point, the operating system becomes fully active, ready to manage resources and enable user interaction. Understanding the boot process shows how the OS transitions from stored data into a working environment, laying the foundation for everything the user sees and does. Now that we've seen how the OS starts up, it's important to understand where it fits alongside firmware and the BIOS. These components often get confused, but they each serve distinct roles. Firmware is low-level software permanently stored on a chip that provides essential instructions for hardware. BIOS, or Basic Input-Output System, a specific type of firmware, initializes and tests hardware components during startup and loads the bootloader and the OS. In contrast, the operating system is the full-featured software layer that takes over once the hardware is ready, managing resources and enabling user interaction. While the BIOS and firmware act as the system's groundwork, the OS provides the functional environment users interact with daily. Next, let's explore how operating systems handle data through file systems and storage. A file system is the method an OS uses to organize and manage data on storage devices like hard drives, SSDs, or flash drives. It determines how files are named, stored, retrieved, and structured into directories and subdirectories. Common file systems include FAT32, NTFS, EXT4, and APFS, each with its own rules and capabilities. The OS uses the file system to keep track of file locations, permissions, and metadata, ensuring quick access and data integrity. Without it, stored data would just be raw, unreadable bytes. Efficient storage management is essential for performance, reliability, and user experience. Now let's explore how operating systems manage users and control access to data. Through user management, the OS can create and maintain individual accounts, each with specific roles, settings, and privileges. Permissions are then assigned to determine what each user or group can do with files and system resources. These typically follow CRUD operations, the ability to create new files, read existing data, update or modify content, and delete what's no longer needed. On top of that, the OS enforces who can execute programs, install software, or make administrative changes. This structure ensures both convenience and security, preventing unauthorized access while allowing legitimate users to safely interact with the system, whether on personal devices or shared networks. In conclusion, operating systems are the unsung heroes of modern computing, coordinating hardware, enabling software, and managing users, files, and memory behind the scenes. From the moment a device powers on to the second you shut it down, the OS is working constantly to keep everything running smoothly. But there's still more beneath the surface. Features like built-in security mechanisms, user privilege levels, and system updates help protect against threats and keep systems stable. And as technology evolves, operating systems now support advanced features like virtualization, allowing one machine to run multiple OS environments at once. In future videos, we'll dive deeper into these areas and uncover how operating systems truly power the digital world around us. That wraps up our dive into operating system basics. If this video helped you understand how your computer really works, consider subscribing and giving it a like. We've got more videos on computer architecture, cybersecurity, and core tech concepts, so be sure to check those out. Don't forget to follow us on Facebook and Instagram for more updates. Thank you for watching.